on that note, then.
There's a report out that Steven Jackson.
Well, let's just end on a high note.
You know, when he's talking to the media, it's a chance, it's another chance to get the message through to the players.
We need to improve and playing coach better next week.
We'll make the adjustments and hopefully be better next week.
I'm trying to get our players to listen to me instead of listening to you guys. You know, all that stuff you write about how good we are and all that stuff they hear on ESPN, it's like poison. You know what I mean? It's like taking poison, like rat poison.
The most honest person I've ever met. Never heard him tell a lie.
When somebody does something wrong, everybody wants to know, how are you going to punish the guy? All right, but there's not enough for 19 and 20-year-old kids, people out there saying, why don't you give him another chance?
You can tell over the years he's gotten a little bit less and less intense in the media. I that wasn't right. He still is very intense, I should say.
We're going to try to win the game, and we're going to play the best players that we can play to win the game. And we're not assuming that it's going to be an easy game, and we're not assuming that we'll have opportunity just to play anybody that wants to play, to expedite anything except winning the game. So we're going to play everybody who can expedite winning the game. That's what we're going to do. So I don't think anybody should expect us to do anything else.
The media has come to expect the mood swings. Their players and staff have come to expect attention to detail in every aspect of every game. Whether Alabama is a 55-point favorite against New Mexico State, or the Patriots are underdogs in Super Bowl 53, where Bill Belichick worries about pregame weather, even in a dome stadium.
John.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Now we're closing the roof, right?
Yeah. Supposed to be closed right at kickoff.
What does that mean? How about before kickoff?
No. They wanted to try to time the kickoff with the Oculus closing. I'm going to delay it a little bit. I would prefer that the roof be completely closed.
Because there's a wind factor now that...
As soon as the flyover goes, it starts to close. How long it takes, I think it's less than 8 minutes.
Not only a great player on the field, but also...
Watch the pop pass!
What they got in there?
And when Nick Saban's team is up by 52 points with 8 seconds left, mental errors are still unacceptable.
Nickel! Timeout! 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 Will you pay attention? We're going to nickel! They subbed late! Damn, man, you guys got no poise! 8 seconds to go in the game, we gotta call timeout because we got 12 guys on the field. Have some pride about what you're doing! Let the guys run right down the field on you. Do your job.
Come on, y'all boys.
Win. Beat him.
You know, I'm never pleased. I'm not disappointed, but I'm not pleased. So we got a lot of things to work on. We got to work on trying to get better.
Goff takes it. Harmon out of blitz. Goff throws it to the right.
Intercepted.
Gilmore's there. Intercepted at the four.
Right there. Yes. That's it.
And the Patriots have won their sixth Super Bowl title.
You know, this is just a great day for our football team. Obviously, Mr. Kraft put this all together, but it's all about the players. These guys work so hard all year.
Even when football comes to a stop, the transition can be difficult.
One of the hardest parts of the year for me is the end of the season. Everything that everybody else has said, Coach, I didn't want to bother you this with you during the season. But now that the season's over, what about this? What about that? Can we do this? Can we do that? You know, that's hard. And I appreciate them holding off until it's over. But then when it's over, honest to God, I feel like it's a tidal wave.
There was a long time when I could not get away. I could not relax. I could not separate. I could not
not think about it. We have a place at Lake Burton, mm-hmm. which is in the mountains on the Georgia-North Carolina border. It's where they made Deliverance. That's the best thing I can say about it. All right, so there's not much there. That's been a salvation for me.
Yeah, I think for me, that probably the big part of that's been Nantucket. You kind of have to separate a little bit, especially right after the season. It just, you're so drained, you're just emotionally just spent.
So I'm not the only one that gets that way.
No.
When my parents bought the property in Nantucket, they bought it with a Super Bowl bonus. It's a peaceful, relaxing place that he can be himself. He can do the things he loves to do. And that's a huge reset for him.
When he's on Nantucket, he's able to shut it down. It's one of the things I really admire about Bill is he can shut it down. He can be with family and be present.
It's the mountains, it's beautiful, the air is fresh, everything's crisp. I'll catch him watching film time and time again or reading over a recruit's profile, but kind of mellows out.
There's a quote by Marcus Aurelius that applies to both of them. The secret to all victory lies in the organization of the non-obvious. Vacation allows them to come back with different ideas. There's an idea you might have when you're out fishing that helps you see the non-obvious.
In 2014, Bill Belichick won a playoff game after seeing a non-obvious formation by Alabama earlier that season.
Derrick Henry is the running back. Well, look at this hot formation. Players all over the field.
It's so difficult to recognize the eligibles in that formation, and especially if you do it fast.
LSU is confused. This guy's not even eligible right here, but he fakes a pass, and they free up the real tight end who was lined up as a tackle.
They get lined up backwards so they don't match the pattern right. And that's exactly what happened, you know, in our game. And I think it happened later for the Patriots, too.
How did Omanawa Nui get so open down here? Well, it was a trick play. Vereen is ineligible.
You know, I watch what they do. I study their schemes. Because I know if it's good enough for Nick and he's doing it, that it's probably good enough for me. I think that's something that Nick and I share. Create an advantage with your attack on the team without doing too much so that your team can't execute that plan.
As hard as it may be to achieve and sustain greatness, Saban and Belichick have done it throughout this decade. Since 2011, their teams have appeared in 11 of a possible 16 title games. With back-to-back wins in 2011 and 2012, Saban caught and temporarily surpassed Belichick for career titles as a head coach. But over the past 5 years, New England and Alabama have alternated championships, bringing each of their totals to 6. Now, in their fifth decade as coaches, they're capable of delivering a masterpiece every time their teams step on the field.
We just need everybody to do their job, all right? There's no new plays. You gotta step up and challenge the line of scrimmage.
In 2014, Belichick's unparalleled preparation led to the last player on his roster making the last play of the game.
Three, Malcolm, go!
Everything's important. It all matters. Plenty of games come down to one play. They come down to the last play. So when it's that close, what's the difference?
Wilson, quick throw. And it's intercepted.
You try to put yourself and your team in the best position that you can to win. Wednesday practice. Malcolm got picked. The receiver went underneath and he couldn't get to him. It was an easy touchdown. So the coaching point was, if they're close enough together, then you've got to be ready to get over the top. In the game, Malcolm anticipated the play that he didn't anticipate as well in practice, got there and, you know, undercut the route.
just an unbelievable turn with a rookie free agent out of West Alabama intercepting the ball on the goal line.
In the end, it really comes down to the players, and it was a great win for our team.
3 years later, Saban's calculated planning led to what may be the boldest and best coaching decision of his life.
This is the second largest deficit under Nick Saban that Bama has had at the half.
Would Nick Saban make the move to Tua Tagovailoa?
It wasn't like an emotional, in-the-moment decision. I knew going into the game, if we struggled throwing the ball, we may have to make this change. I wasn't looking to do it. I just said, if it happened that way. Well, we gave Jalen every chance, missed a couple throws that could have been big plays.
Throws it for the end zone, but over the head of Ridley.
That's on Hurts.
He had it.
It wasn't working. I just said, if we're going to have a chance to win this game, we need to give Tua a chance because we've got great skill guys on offense and we're not utilizing them at all.
The freshman from Eva Beach, Hawaii, Tua Tagovailoa, is the quarterback for Alabama.
One of the things that makes Nick Saban great is he has strong conviction. He has strongly held beliefs. And for him to make that decision at halftime, with a quarterback who's had so much success for him, but I think deep down he felt this is the move we need to make. He was able to convince his coaches and his players that this was the right thing, and they all responded the right way.
You feel the momentum shift to his brawl and energy to this offense.
It was not a simple decision. I think it was, I mean, you're sitting there with a pretty good football team, and you're making a major change in what is the largest stage there is.
Here's Tua. He looks, stands in. Everybody's covered. He'll throw to the left side. Caught by Alabama in the end zone.
Tua just has an instinctive flair about his play.
We're going to overtime. Here's Tua stepping back. Holds up. Looks long. Throws. End zone. Touchdown. Alabama and the Crimson Tide has once again ascended to the top of the college football mountain. Their fifth championship in 9 years.
Coach, share some love, man.
Yeah, we got to
guys,
you're a hell of a job. Love
success isn't the only element that links these coaches.
What a night.
There's also their families and the struggle to find balance in a life that leaves almost no room for it.
I don't think you can invest as much as we have in terms of time and commitment to a standard of excellence and not say that it's been a sacrifice for everyone involved in supporting you from a family standpoint. Would that be a fair statement?
Definitely. I thought that being a coordinator, when I was a coordinator of the Giants, that was a really good balance. There was more family time. Coach Parcells had to deal with all the problems. And I really was, you know, had a much better balanced life.
I think that even though my children probably at times, and Miss Terry, resented the fact that I spent so much time, you know, trying to be successful, but I also think that they have a great appreciation for the time that you did have and that you did spend was good time. I think that's the most important thing.
It's a special moment for any daughter getting married to walk with her dad. I just feel really fortunate that I was able to do that with him, given what he does and how absent he is sometimes.
Those are precious moments that, you know, are bigger than any individual game or even season.
That's about as special as it gets, and I'll never forget that.
That moment, walking down the aisle and doing the father-daughter dance, that's my, like, sacred moment with him.
For both men, it turns out football isn't everything after all. Maybe part of the art of coaching is once in a while appreciating everything else life can give you.
Those sweet moments were really awesome, but when he had his speech, the sentiment that really stands out to me was just how proud he is of me as a person.
On October 8th, 1984, we had a Monday night game when I was with the Giants. It's a brutal game. Down 28-1-0, 6 minutes into the game, and got hammered. But the shining ray of light that night, a little bit after midnight on the 9th, Amanda came into the world. And
you know, we are really, really proud of Kristen. She has been a blessing, you know, in our life. She has a tremendous spirit, a tremendous grit about her that you just have to love.
She came into the world, and I was captured by her blue eyes, her smile. And it's been a true privilege, Amanda, to be your father. You've been a tremendous love, and so thank you.
And this is a wonderful day for her. But no matter what happens, she's always going to be my little Krista Bina.
AJ and Amanda.
Football has given them remarkable lives. But even through the greatest celebrations, each of them, as they head towards 70 years of age, are still looking for more. They are two sons of coaches, now grandfathers. Two ambitious assistants, now legends. Two masters of detail, still an inspiration to anyone who appreciates the art of coaching.
There's nobody I respect more in football than Nick Saban, and I don't think there's anybody that's a better coach than Nick Saban. What he's accomplished as a football coach, I mean, I think is unparalleled. I mean, I look up to him, I admire what he's done, and I've learned a ton from Nick.
I think that sometimes people have a real true love and respect for someone. You really love to see them have this success and continue to have this success. And I don't know how many people really could understand, you know, that kind of relationship. And that's kind of how I feel about Bill. People always ask about how do you stay motivated or what keeps you going. I mean, every year we have a team. You're building a whole new team, a whole new chemistry. So the challenge is like starting over. You know, like this is the first year at Alabama.
And you're playing 12 other new teams.
12 other new teams.
Because whoever they were last year, they're not the same.
Yeah. So the challenge is always there.
100%.
All right, guys. Sorry we got practice today, so.
What time are you out there?
We start meeting with the players at 2, and we'll be on the field at 3:30.
Do you all do squad meetings on the installs?
Yeah.
Oh, you do the squad meetings?
The whole defense.
Oh, okay.
I don't represent.
Right.
But we're not having a team meeting today.
Yeah, I got you. So the zone coverage, do you move the gaps over?
We do two things. Anytime the jack walks, it turns into cut.
CB on the beat, homie.
Wasted. GTA love, bitches wasted. I'm on these drugs, I feel.